Hi everyone in cloud computing and welcome to episode 32 of the Cloud Computing Training Show with Brad Nelson and internationally recognized and world's number one cloud industry expert and thought leader David Linthicum. This show is sponsored by Nelson Hilliard, cloud computing recruitment specialist placing great people in cloud, IoT, fintech and AI. In this week's show, David and I are talking about certifications measure knowledge and skills against industry benchmarks to help you prove to employees that you have the right mix of cloud skills, knowledge and expertise. Make sure you stay until the end to get David's top three cloud certification tips. Hi Dave, great to have you on another Cloud Computing Training Show this week.
Yeah, it's great to be here, and this is a great topic. I'm looking to rant and rave about this, so let's go.
Yeah, 100%. We've had some great shows this week. So if this is the first show you're getting through Twitter or Facebook or YouTube or however you're finding us, make sure you go back to the other shows we've done this week for Australia, which is Australia, but kind of a global thing as well this week, all about government stuff and spending on cloud, and also the C-Suite show. So that was a really good one as well. We were talking about health tech and healthcare and cloud, etc. So if you haven't watched those ones yet, make sure you go back and check those ones out. They're pretty cool. So Dave, let's open up the show with this question, because I think we've got a lot to talk about on this one, especially you have, I know this. Are we putting too much weight on certifications when it comes to cloud?
I think in a word, yeah, we are. And I think this is something we discussed kind of vaguely and as side topics on other shows. So let's talk about it directly. And so, you know, this article is basically the top 10 certifications everybody needs to have and things like that. And certainly AWS certifications are money in the bank, just like, you know, NetWare certified, Cisco certified, you know, all the other things that existed in the past. And if it's a hot skill and you get certified in it and you pay whomever is going to certify you, in this case, AWS, Google or Microsoft or Alibaba or whomever, IBM, then you're going to be able to typically talk your way into a job and, you know, start, you know, making some pretty big money. And so, you know, it's not unusual for people with AWS certified skills and a bit of experience, you know, to make well over, you know, 20%, 30% that others in their same sort of experience level make. And so I see the reason why people are getting certifications. However, I don't think certifications as a standalone metric are really a good metric to evaluate people's ability to build cloud-based solutions. So it's basically their ability to do tactical things within a particular cloud. So if I get AWS certified, I can build systems and I can run dashboards and I can do maintenance systems on it. I can, you know, spin up regions, you know, spin up servers within regions and do all the things I need to do to keep that happen. But the reality is we need to get people thinking in terms of how they're going to build these systems, how to get our kind of an architectural creativity and how these things are really going to be put together. What's happening now is that we're moving from a single cloud deployment, you know, such as just AWS to AWS and Microsoft or AWS, Microsoft and Google or AWS, Microsoft and Alibaba, whatever. And therefore, people are finding they can't get certified in everything out there. They're going to have to become kind of a generalist in certain ways in terms of understanding how multi-cloud comes together. And you're stumping these people because they're just getting tactical skills. We're asking them to think strategically in terms of how we're going to get management, performance, monitoring, you know, holistic abstract security, all these other things that are important in building these very strategically important cloud-based systems, multi-cloud-based systems. They have no clue how to do it. And so I think that the certifications are important to do the tactical skills, but they still need to take the architecture classes. They still need to get the on-the-job training. They still need to work with a mentor to get them to the point where they can be much more valuable to the enterprises that are employing them. And I think enterprises really need to start asking questions in terms of what else they know beyond certification. Are they really kind of having a holistic view of architecture, holistic view of security, holistic view of governance versus just the tactical view within the certifications that they get? And so if people show up on my doorstep looking for a job and they have a list of certifications that they have, that's certainly going to pique my interest because that skills that I need. However, if they don't have the holistic knowledge, they don't have the creativity, they don't have the innovation aspect, and they don't have the ability to kind of learn on the fly, which is probably more important just to, you know, getting certification, then I'm not going to want to leverage them, because while they're going to be valuable to me, you know, for AWS or Google or Microsoft for a certain period of time, eventually we're going to move on to other technology stacks. And unless they're able to pivot over to those technology stacks, whether they be cloud, multi-cloud, you know, whatever, they're not going to be valuable to me as someone who's able to do that. In fact, I'd rather hire someone without the certification but has the ability to learn on the fly, who may not have the tactical capabilities in certain clouds, because they're going to have more longevity, they're going to have more value to me long term.
Oh, Dave, you've taken the words right out of my mouth. I mean, there are so many indicators there with regards to people jumping on the shiny objects. You know, what certifications do they need? Is it an AWS? Is it Azure? Is it Google? You know, it really, from a recruitment point of view, if I put my recruitment hat or head on when we're doing these shows, and sometimes I don't do that often, we're more objective around the industry and around the topic we're talking about. But from a recruitment point of view, you know, the key drivers for me are passion and soft skills and seeing where they sit. Because like you say, you've got more interest in someone that's got the adaptability to learn on the fly, that can be, you know, find a mentor, find how to do stuff. Obviously, they're going to have experience within the industry and they're going to have, you know, a technical ability within an IT community. But soft skills and culture are massive, like absolutely huge. So, you know, and again, it comes back to not only from an individual coming to be represented by Nelson Hilliard, but equally from a point of view of the questions that are asked the employer looking to fill a position. What does the culture look like? What does the role look like? What's the expectation on the role? What are the outputs for the role? So, you know, it's really important. You know, people more often than not contact me about, you know, this actual topic. You know, what are the certifications I need to get into cloud? You know, where's the gold? Where's the pot of gold? What's the answer to that question, where I'm going to get that, you know, $100,000+ a year? You know, I'm going to get exactly what I want, etc., etc. And it really is, you know, identifying, I think it comes down to one of the main things, emotional intelligence. Emotional intelligence in the workplace is gold. And I think, you know, the skills can be learnt, and, you know, it can take time to develop emotional intelligence with working with people, making sure you understand a cultural fit, you know, and that works both ways, from an employer point of view or a direct line manager point of view, as to the, you know, the actual AWS certified professional that's going to fulfill the role. So I think emotional intelligence and that cultural fit is key, like you said, and also, you know, learning on the fly, again, like you said, I think they're really key things. You know, people look appealing on paper when they've got the AWS certifications or the security certifications and things like that. They look great. We know they can, you know, we know they can study. We don't actually know that they're going to be the round peg in the round hole, you know, because more often than not, sometimes I found, you know, you may have the most studious, educated academic individual, but they are the square peg in the round hole. And unfortunately, that lets them down when it comes to, you know, employment or longevity within a particular role. What are your thoughts on that, Dave?
No, I think that's spot on. I think that we focus too much on degrees and certifications and things like that. And I understand why. We've always been focused on college degrees and master's degrees and all these sorts of things. I don't think they're as important as someone's ability to learn on the fly and pivot and manage their own career path. And there's no other way to look at, you know, if you look at the leaders of the Global 2000 companies, I mean, few of them went to Harvard and Yale, but, you know, a lot of them went to community college and worked their way up within the organization. And they've just learned to be more adaptive and more intuitive in terms of how they're doing their jobs than having the book skills and the book learning and the certifications and the SAT scores and things like that, that we have a tendency to overemphasize in the space. And I think we're doing the same thing within cloud. I understand it's easy to get certification and get people branded as knowledgeable in a particular skill, but that's not knowledge. That's basically them having a tactical understanding of a particular technology, which is fine. But, you know, I've had a tactical understanding of 100 different technologies in my career, and I'm going to have a tactical understanding of 100 other technologies, you know, before my career ends. And my ability to learn on the fly and figure out what those things are and, you know, recreate the knowledge in my head in terms of grounding it into my, you know, base of knowledge as to what it is probably more important than me having an understanding of how something works. I mean, we're not going to use the same technology for the next 10 years. We're going to use it for the most part 2 years, and we're going to switch and pivot to other things. And so people who are able to do that are going to be much more valuable to the enterprise than people who are looking for just tactical skills.
100%, absolutely right. And look, you know, people watching this video, if this is a topic that's of interest, we'd love to hear about it. So, you know, you can get David on Twitter. I'm also on Twitter. And at the end of the show, I'll have the Twitter handles on the screen. And equally, you know, put your comments in the box below if there's any questions around this training and certifications and all the things that you'd like to know about. You know, put it to us. You can ask us directly on the YouTube channel below. So, you know, check that out. So, look, Dave, it moves on nicely to the towards the end of the show now, where we like to talk about your top three tips. So I guess we're going to be talking about your top three certification tips, Dave. What are they?
Yeah, focus on knowledge, not certifications. I mean, we said that during this this whole show, and I can't stress that enough. So, you know, people who have the ability to be autodidacts and learn on the fly and self-teach and things like that are much more valuable to you than people who have to have classroom training and get certifications. And by the way, that doesn't mean that certifications aren't important, because there's lots of people who are excellent architects that also have certifications, but there's people who have certifications that are not excellent architects. Beware of people who rely too much on certifications they have. You know, I always do this with colleges and degrees and things like that. I just had a lot of bad luck with people with master's degrees and, you know, bachelor's degrees in very prestigious universities, and really kind of being a metric as to whether or not they're going to be valuable to me or not in doing the work. And the reality is that people sometimes can be good at getting degrees and getting certifications and taking tests, but not as good at doing things on the job. They can be, by the way. You shouldn't discount people because they have a good degree, because they may be excellent people, but we need to kind of drill into them in terms of what their capabilities are. So in other words, if I always ask the question, I says, if, you know, Amazon Web Services went away in the next 2 years and something else popped up in its place, you know, what would you do to, you know, train yourself in that new area? And if they say, well, I have to get recertified and test and study and things like that, that's not what I want to hear. What I want to hear is I'm going to take that on as a challenge, be innovative and creative. I'm going to take my knowledge of what I did in AWS, transfer it to this new particular technology, figure out what's going on. I'll take the certifications is really kind of part of that, but that's going to be holistic to my understanding of the new technology. That's probably a more satisfactory answer than I need to get recertified. I need to go to training. Please, you know, I need to depend on other people to teach me. And then mix on the job training with training. There's no experience like getting things done. And so the metric is people, you know, if you're going to get an AWS certification or Microsoft certification, well, make it happen. You know, in other words, you have to, you know, go ahead and start doing some things, you know, versus sitting in training. And that should be part of the training. So in other words, it's one thing to get training. It's another thing to actually do it in real life. And the reality is I like to see people get trained who are also doing OJT.
Great tips there, Dave. Great tips. And look, you know, I put a message out there to everyone that's watching these training shows, the C-Suite shows, Australia shows, and a part of the growing tribe that we have at Nelson Hilliard Cloud Computing Recruitment Specialists. It's great. Look, you know, we're here to help as much as we can when it comes to cloud computing. It's very exciting. It's a huge market that really is growing at great knots, and a global market, not just territory within Australia that we obviously talk about on a weekly basis, but globally it's massive. And David and I are here and we offer that olive branch to make sure that, you know, you can reach out to us and talk to us about what's going on, and we implore that interaction. So we love that interaction about, you know, with people in regards to the shows and on Twitter, and David and I write blogs as well about cloud computing and lots of other different topics around that sort of disruptive technology market, and we'd be more than happy to talk. So do feel free to reach out on Twitter. So look, here comes the Twitter time. You can get David on Twitter, which is at David Linthicum. I am also on Twitter, which is at Nelson_Hilliard. So reach out with us and ask any questions you have. And, you know, if we haven't got the answer, then, you know, no one will have the answer, basically, because Dave's the world's number one cloud industry expert. So if he hasn't got the answer, then it's a great question. Look, Dave, thanks for being part of another great training show this week. We've covered some great ground.
Yeah, it's great. It's great to be on the show again. Thank you, Brad.
Thanks, man. And thanks for watching, everyone. We really do hope you enjoyed watching this week's training show. Again, reach out if you have any questions. We'd be happy to help. I'll do the Twitters again. So David's on Twitter, which is at David Linthicum. I'm also on Twitter, which is at Nelson_Hilliard. Remember to like, subscribe to the channel so you don't miss out on any future videos. And obviously, there's lots more before this. I think we're on the 32nd show. So yeah, there's 31 previous to this, obviously. Check those out as well. And yeah, look forward to next week. Thanks for watching.